Hello all, welcome to the new video of Signals and Systems. In this video, we'll see the working of Costas receiver. So, Costas receiver is a negative feedback system that is used to generate the local carrier necessary for the demodulation of DS-BSE signals. So, we'll see the block diagram and the I will show you what each block means. Okay, so this Costas receiver, it consists of two coherent detectors. Okay, there are two coherent detectors in this Costas receiver. One coherent detector is in the upper side and one is in the below. You can see here product modulator followed by low pass filter. So each of these coherent detectors are supplied with same input signal, that is DS-BSE wave is fed to both of these coherent detectors. So this receiver, what it will do, it will generate a carrier which is used to demodulate this S of T. Okay, we need a message signal out of this DS-BSE wave. Since double sideband suppressed carrier wave doesn't have the carrier, we need to generate it at the receiver. Then only we can demodulate the signal. So, as you can see, this product modulator is fed with local oscillator. However, the signals are in quadrature to each other. As you can see, this voltage controlled oscillator will generate say cos 2 pi x t plus theta. So, this is one oscillator, I mean carrier signal, and there is another carrier signal fed to second coherent detector, but that carrier is in quadrature with this signal. Okay, since it is cos, it is in sign. So since the carrier signals are in quadrature to each other, this first coherent detector is called as I channel detector, and this is called I channel. And this coherent detector which you are seeing in the below diagram, that is product modulator followed by low pass filter, is called Q channel detector. So this feedback system has the objective to maintain the local oscillator output in synchronous with the carrier used at the transmitter. So we'll see in detail the working now. I think you are familiar with this block diagram, because in every coherent detection there will be a product modulator followed by low pass filter, and there will be a local oscillator generated at the receiver side. But in Costas receiver, what you have, we have local oscillator which produces signals which are in quadrature with each other. So we'll see what is the benefit of doing in this way. So we'll see that. So before understanding how Costas receiver works, we must understand how coherent detection works, and also we must understand what are the necessary conditions or criteria for efficient coherent detection. So, in coherent detection method, the message signal can be recovered by modulated wave S of T by first multiplying the modulated wave S of T. In our case, the DS-BSE wave, we can recover message signal from DS-BSE wave by first multiplying it with local carrier and then passing the product to the low pass filter. But whenever we are using coherent detection method, we must ensure that the local oscillator signal must have same frequency and phase as the carrier which was used in the transmitter end. So there are two blocks in communication systems. There is a transmitter end, and then there is something called as receiver. So in order to modulate a message signal, we have used one carrier say FC. So this signal will have some frequency and some phase. So in order to recover the message signal from the modulated wave, we must generate a carrier signal which has same frequency and has same phase, which was used in the transmitter end. So this is very important. So in communication systems, it is, you can generate a signal which has same frequency, but to maintain phase it is very tough. So what Costas receiver does is it employs a negative feedback system which makes sure that the carrier generated at the receiver end has same frequency and same phase as that of carrier signal which was used in the transmitter end. By ensuring all these things, we can be sure that the message signal can be recovered by the modulated wave, and the message signal will be exact replica of that of a message. There will not be any distortion or anything like that. So these are the necessary conditions. So we will see how Costas receiver will make sure that the local oscillator signal will have same frequency and same phase as that of carrier. So let's see the working of Costas receiver. So it consists of two coherent detectors. As I said, first we pass the modulated wave, in our case DSPSC wave, to the product modulator, which has two inputs. One is of S of T and another is local oscillator signal, that is cos 2 pi FCT. This FC is same frequency, we have same frequency as that of carrier used in the transmitter. Let's say our carrier at the transmitter end had theta is equal to 0. In that case, let's assume that this voltage controlled oscillator has produced a carrier where theta is equal to 0 and FC is same as that of the carrier used in the transmitter. In that case, what happens? Let theta equal to 0. Then what happens? This S of T will get multiplied with cos 2 pi FCT, and then it is passed to the low pass filter. So if you have forgotten what is how S of T looks like, S of T is nothing but M of T AC cos 2 pi FCT. Okay, so this M of T AC cos 2 pi FCT will get multiplied with cos 2 pi FCT because theta is equal to 0, and then we pass it to low pass filter. So we'll end up with our message signal M of T, which is AC by 2 M of T and cos theta. Okay, and this S of T is the same, will get multiplied with sin 2 pi FCT since theta is equal to 0, and then we'll pass through low pass filter. We'll get output here as AC by 2 M of T and sin theta. So what happens under this condition, we find that the output of I channel contains the desired message signal M of T, because cos 0 is equal to 1, input theta equal to 0, we get AC by 2 M of T. So there you have your message signal. If it is audio signal, you can hear the voice there, okay, which was sent at the transmitter end. Since sine of 0 is 0, this will get vanished. This is 0. Okay. So this is one case which is simple. If this was the case all the time, then Costas receiver would be of no use, because if you make sure that theta is, you can generate a carrier which has same phase and frequency as that of carrier, no need to use a negative feedback system. But we cannot always generate this type of signal. There will be effectively some phase generated at the by the local oscillator. So this theta will not be 0, however the carrier which was generated at the transmitter had 0 phase. So let's see a case where theta is equal is not equal to 0 in the next segment. So first we studied the case where theta is equal to 0. At that time what happened? We got our message signal at the I channel, and this Q channel output at the Q channel was 0, since sine 0 is 0. So we had the message signal, we recovered the message signal from the VSPSC wave. So this was all possible because we assumed theta was 0. That is, the carrier signal generated by the local oscillator had 0 phase, that is same phase as that of carrier used in the transmitter end. However, it is not possible for this local oscillator to generate the carrier signal, local oscillator signal, which has same frequency and same phase as that of carrier. So let's see what happens if theta is not equal to 0. At that time what happens? Sine 0 is not 0. It's not 0. So there will be some component over here. Okay. And we'll be having some component here. So both of these are fed to the phase discriminator. What it will do? It will generate some DC value, and this DC value is fed to the local oscillator. So this DC signal will change the operating point of voltage controlled oscillator. So in return what will happen? This voltage controlled operator oscillator, based on this DC signal, will bring down theta to 0. So whole of the system will make sure that theta is equal to 0 if it was 0 in the transmitter end. So let's see two cases. This theta can be greater than 0 or less than 0. Okay. So since this diagram has used the notation phi, I have used phi. Okay. In our case, both theta and phi are one and the same. Okay. So if phi is greater than 0 or theta is greater than 0, it means the local oscillator signal, you can see in this blue signal, is leading over the carrier signal. So internally what happens is, temporarily the frequency of the local oscillator is decreased till it catches with the carrier wave. So that's how it will make sure that phi, if phi is greater than 0, some internal operations will happen and eventually phi will become 0. That is, these two signal will match. You can see there is some difference over here. So both will, after the change, the temporary change, what will happen? This red signal will follow the local oscillator signal. At that time, both are synchronous. Then there will be efficient recovery of the message signal. And also, there may be a case where the carrier is leading the local oscillator signal. At that time, what we should do? We should increase the, temporarily increase the frequency of this local oscillator. Temporarily increase this. Okay. Sorry, I should have used temporarily. Internally it happens. Okay. You need not worry about it. Temporarily increase the frequency of local oscillator signal. At that time what happens? If you increase the frequency, so it will be here, and finally these two will match. Okay. And then when it matches, so that's how some mechanism is going on internally. You need not worry. Just understand that this Costas receiver will make sure that this blue signal and red signal are matching both in frequency and in phase. So that at that time what happens, it will follow in this manner. Okay. So that's how this Costas receiver works. So if there is a change in the value of theta or phi, I mean both the notations are same, at that time this local oscillator will change its operating point and make sure at the end make sure that both FC and theta are in match with the back of carrier signal, and you will get the output at the I channel if theta is equal to 0, and this will be 0. So that is the working of Costas receiver. If you have any doubts, please use the comment section. And if you need any study material regarding this Costas receiver, I'll be happy to mail you guys. So please contact me. So thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe to our channel and spread the word. Thank you.